Nearly 3 million more Americans filed for first-time unemployment benefits last week. Now, that is 36.5 million Americans out of work since mid-March. Kentucky has had the highest unemployment rate in the country, with the pandemic putting nearly a third of the state's labor force out of work. CNN's Vanessa Yurkovic has more.
How tight are things for you right now?
Right now, things are, I'm to my like last $100.
In Kentucky, one in three workers are out of a job right now. Jerrica Horn is one of them. A hairdresser from Winchester, she says she's been waiting 6 weeks for unemployment.
Could unemployment be a game changer for you and your family?
Oh my God, yeah. Like anything I'd be thankful for. Just so I can have a peace of mind, like I've got this money to fall back on. To at least buy groceries.
Kentucky's workforce now has the highest share of unemployment claims in the U.S., according to the Labor Department. One reason, Kentucky's Governor Andy Beshear told people to file, and early.
Apply for benefits.
I ask people every day when I have an update to sign up for unemployment. I actually encourage them to do it. We were one of the first and most aggressive states in opening up unemployment to independent contractors, to small business owners, trying to make sure that everybody that was truly harmed could get help.
But encouragement from state officials alone doesn't account for high jobless claims. Kentucky's leading industry, manufacturing, plays a role. It's nearly 13% of the state's workforce, higher than the national average.
Those workers, it's much harder for them to work remotely, as you can imagine. So that may not be an option for a lot of the employers in Kentucky.
And two of the state's biggest employers, Toyota and Ford, are shut down.
When the auto industry shuts down, what does that mean for you?
That means that they don't need my parts.
Gibbs Die Casting supplies the big three automakers with parts. Greg Risch became CEO just 7 weeks ago. His first action, furloughing 670 of his 800 employees.
There's no work available, so they're obviously filing for unemployment and, you know, getting all the aid that's been available from the states as well.
Also on hold, the Kentucky Derby. A huge economic driver, now postponed till September, leaving businesses without $400 million in tourism dollars.
You know, we're seeing reduced demand for their products, and so their employees are being affected as well.
Parts of Kentucky's economy are reopening with a phased approach, but slower than its neighboring states.
What's going to separate states and what their economy is going to look like by the end of the year is how well they reopen. If you go too fast, you have a spike and you have to shut down again, that's going to cause more long-term damage than doing it gradually and doing it right.
Nearly 70,000 Kentucky residents applied for unemployment benefits last week. That's down from the prior week, continuing a downward trend. Still, the number of laid-off Kentuckians seeking jobless assistance in the past 8 weeks is approaching 750,000.